Today we had unbelievable experience. We try to make a real Uzbekistan plov from a family recipe of our friends Alex and Alena from Maybelline Selling.
To have a recipe of this unique dish from a first hand, it's a big luck. I hope you will enjoy this video.
Hi guys, today we are cooking really Uzbekistan pilau with real Uzbekistan people. They are also living on a boat. You can find all information about them on YouTube downstairs, maybe Selling. Алена.
Алена.
Знаешь, местные говорят, что узбекский плов это рис, морковь, лук, чеснок. Что еще?
Тогда может получиться каша. Шавля.
Шавля. Но у нас не шавля, у нас плов.
У нас будет плов.
Carrot, onion, garlic, rice. Have to be special rice in Uzbekistan. We are in Spain now, so we will have just redondo. And special spices. Что за специи?
Узбекские специи. Кинза и зира.
This is cumin and coriander.
Оранжевую морковь, а желтую. Она менее сочная, может быть, но она сохраняет свою структуру.
Special trick. Normally I never heard it, but exists yellow carrot. And for Uzbekistan pilau, you normally use yellow carrot because it's not so sweet, but it's still have a shape after you cook it. Special way of cutting carrot. For Uzbekistan pilau, it have to be really thick pieces, but in the end, in a dish, we will feel a carrot. And they have special type of cutting. So you make half, and then you cut...
В Узбекистане делают длинные.
So in...
Вдоль. Или по диагонали, или вдоль. Туза, что держать?
Special way of cutting onion, also for pilau, from Uzbekistan. You have to leave this tail and...
Держишь за этот. Пилау средний. Тогда еще я разрезаю пополам. Вообще вот половинки, вот такие самые идеальные. Такой рис. Здесь в Испании подают для паэльи. Он более такой, который не разваривается.
The round rice, and in Spain it also can be rice for paella. And idea is to wash rice very well. We have to clean it till water will be transparent. The most important thing for pilau to clean very well rice.
Им где-то 8 год говорят, надо слить. Говорят. Они же тоже не подпроточные. Они наливают воду. Уже смыли основное.
Yeah, you can see rice start to be with blue structure, white and little transparent. It means that we already on the way to make it really clean. And you have to be very careful always with rice to not break it. So this is cumin and zira, 1 tablespoon. So ideal that we will not make it in a powder, it have to be still some structure. Okay, yeah. Fantastic. We don't have kazan, it's special type of a dish for pilau, but with quite the same form, we have a wok. Different is that wok is with thin walls. We need normally for kazan, it's more heavy one, but we will try. Best oil, it's from cotton. But of course, in Spain is no cotton oil, so we will mix sunflower and sesame oil. About meat for pilau. Normally you use a lamb. And what Alena said, it has to be quite big pieces. First you fry it, and then you cut it smaller after fry. We in Spain, we can just found some leg, and we already cut it in small pieces. But normally, if you have a chance to find the big pieces of lamb, then make it first of all fry big. And one trick is special. Normally, how to check that your oil is ready? Uzbekistan people using match. You will take a match, put it inside, and then match start to burn. Then in this moment, oil is ready. One more moment, what we have to accept now, but normally if you have a chance, use metal one. And for pilau, it have to be with holes inside. We have no chance to have it now, we will use what we have. Ideally in Uzbekistan, if you use less oil, you can put kurduk. Kurduk, this is on male lamb, they have on the ass some special bubble with a fat. So when you cut this fat and put inside, then it will be less oil, but it will be more fatty one, because this fat from the ass of the lamb really, really have some special smell and sabor, but yeah, we don't have it. We just use oil. And so now, first we are frying meat. And this meat, then to the meat you put or onion first or carrot. If you put first onion, it will give you some caramelized taste, what Alena said the best. Or you can put carrot, then it will be more sweet taste of the pilau. So you can choose what you put first.
Бросаем по одному куску, и нужно, чтобы по кругу мясо сформировалось корочка, да, короче.
So, what we have to do, we will fry and put inside piece by piece. The most important that around each of the piece we will have some brown skin. This is the most important part in the fry.
You can see we are build a really brown skin around, but be careful, it's really oil start to shut. Flushing.
Для меня это первый опыт вок, плов готовить.
Для меня вообще первый опыт плова этот. So it's for us some experiment, because we don't have really kazan, so, and this is the thin walls, we will try to reach this high temperature, but we will see.
Все, забираем все, что мы перемололи, вот он так разведет.
So this is normally one tablespoon of mixed cumin and coriander. This is we're making zervak. Zervak, this is all what we have before rice put inside of the dish. Fried pieces of meat, the big one. Now Alena put spices, freshly ground. And then we will put first onion and carrot. If you put first onion, it will be more caramelized onion taste of the pilau. If you put carrot, it will be more sweet. Мы готовим для себя. We are cooking with hands, because this is like real Uzbekistan people are cooking. Normally you cook for your family, for your friends, and
каждый может If
you feel not comfortable cooking with hands, you can put gloves, but we are cooking with hands. Wow, yeah. Chat, your food, huh? Look. Yum, yum.
Yum. 1 kilo.
1 kilo of onion, can you imagine? Alena said the onion and carrot have to be really a lot because you will never can make bad pilau with amount of onion and carrot.
I hope you are listening.
Well, cooking on the open air, so we have to protect a little bit of power of our flame. Idea in this moment is that onion have to give all water, all juice to the meat to start to marinate it. And our main goal to put all liquid away from this mixture of onion and meat. То есть мы выпариваем лук, готовим на свежем воздухе, и поэтому нам приходится вот, да, так обеспечивать огонь, поддерживать пламя.
Я могу вот так вот.
Now we are in a stage, when you can see that onion start to be more caramelized, and now we are ready to put the carrot.
Раз, два, три.
Раз, два, три. Морковка. Wow! Wow! Yeah, and now we put a carrot. And now idea that we have to fry also juice away from a carrot. Wow! But actually, I cannot see space for rice already. Я не вижу места, где будет рис.
1 kilo of rice.
Yeah.
Ему места нет. Пока готовится зервак, места для риса нет.
Yeah, while you preparing зервак, it's never space for the rice. Wow.
Половина.
So half of tablespoon of salt. Now it's time to put the water.
Что-то к нам прилипло. Хватит. Вот так вот.
We put water inside.
И поменьше сделать огня.
And now we make a small fire. On the rack we put a little bit of salt. How you saw it was half of a hand. Half of a tablespoon. Because we want that our meat inside put suck a little bit of salt inside, because normally, mainly, we will put the salt on the rice later. So this is was just for a meat, a little bit. And what Alena told very nice, how you make a pilau. Normally for, and I would like that you don't say any more pilau. In Russia, in Uzbekistan, this is plov. It's not so difficult to say. Yeah, Shat, can you say plov?
Plov.
So not so difficult. So let's talk how it's really called this name. This is plov. And you make a plov for your friends or guests when they come. And the main what you are making while you're waiting for them, zervak. Zervak is ready and you wait for your friends and family. When they ring on your door and in this moment you start to prepare a pilau, plov. You start to prepare plov. Ay-ay-ay,
plov.
And now we put up rice inside and we wait just 40 minutes and we can eat.
Нужный рис так закрыть. И максимально поставить этот огонь сразу, да.
So we have to make it again very strong. Now we put salt to the rice.
Ну, это вот где-то столовая, да, ложка?
Угу.
То есть, когда заливаем водой, перед тем, как заливаем водой, надо посолить.
So, the most important and plov, zervak, то, что мы делали, what we made from meat and vegetables and rice, we just cover, we don't mix nothing. So what was first cooking is inside, and rice is just like a top. Yeah?
Мы наливаем ее на шумовку и через дырочки в ризе.
Okay. So, yeah, idea, we have to have a spoon with a hole inside, small holes. Then we put the water, and water is spread in the rice, and don't make holes in the rice. This is very important. So if you use kazan, then it's normally 2 fingers of water. We use a wok, and it's quite
maximum
big surface, so we will put a little bit less. Why you need this sushi stick? Зачем тебе эта палочка для суши? So it's some secret feature to make a plov. And Alena said that without this stick, plov will be not plov. Just for plov.
Металлическая, да? Стучат вот так вот по верху. Бум-бум-бум. А она дает, ну как, показывает, насколько осталось воды внизу. Я заглядываю сейчас вот так вот, посмотреть, что у нас с водой. И нам уже пора с тобой сейчас уменьшать огонь до минимума.
Окей.
Мы сейчас вот так вот берем.
Now we have to put fire very slow, because normally if we would have a normal tool with the holes, we will heat rice on top and see how many water left over. Now Alena open it to see how many water. And now it's exactly time to make fire very, very low, that plov start to be cooking, no? Preparing, I don't know.
Поэтому, если ты готовишь в казане, вот рис, этот зервак, ты до него не доберешься. Ты просто собираешь с боков.
Рис горкой.
Рис горкой, да. Обязательно горочкой вот так собираешь все с боков. Горочкой.
So the most important, you don't touch this zervak, what you made before. You just have to put all rice with some heel on top. Mix. Never mix plov.
Горкой собирают, но вот то, что снизу зервак, он должен снизу остаться.
Да, в правильном плове ты будешь видеть только рис.
So if it's a real plov, you will see just rice, nothing else. И момент for magic stick.
Очень важный момент.
Very important moment.
Центр. И делаем
отверстие. Не дырку, дырки в других местах.
Такое.
So this is very important moment in a plov. You have to put stick. You put stick inside and make this holes that later on steam will go out from these holes. The minimum, minimum fire have to be. Now it's a moment of minimum. If it's possible, less, less is possible. The most important also the top. It have to be like a not flat one. It have to be also with some heel. Сейчас 30 minutes and we can eat. You can watch it ready.
Плов по науке надо накладывать в ляган. Но поскольку у нас нет лягана, мы будем использовать аналог.
Паяльница.
Похож, да. Он похож. Ляган.
Ляган for the ляган.
Yeah. So normally in Uzbekistan you use a special plate to put a plov. It's named ляган. We don't have one, but we have паэлья pan. So we will use паэлья pan like ляган.
есть большие куски мяса можно отдельно убирать и...
Вообще по этикету их кладут на вот аккуратную горку, скажем так, плова, и там все едят рис руками там по-разному, и в конце уже там потом потихоньку к мясу добираются.
Короче, нет, мясо сверху накладывают.
Так я и говорю, да, ты рис кушаешь, мясо к тебе раз скатывается. То есть там, там свой этикет, там все не просто.
Так, окей.
Кому скатилось, тот ест.
Окей.
А кто плохо кушал рис, там и не достает себе мясо.
Браво. So, Shats, I have to explain it.
Normally, to eat plov, you put in lagan with some hill, and pieces of meat you put on top. And traditionally, plov you eat by hand. So you have on the top of a mountain, you have a meat. Around you have rice. But you need to imagine that this plate will be like this size, so this size. And first you eat rice. You cannot touch meat first. You eat rice. Eat rice, and then maybe if you are lucky, piece of meat can fall down to you. Then this is my meat. You can eat it, but first you have to be good boy and girl and eat a lot of rice.
Так и было. Оно это готовое.
Да, оно вот настолько мягкое, эластичное, что оно вот легко вот так вот вот оно. Настолько оно прожарилось.
Ну, этот трюк только, наверное, с бараниной можно. Другое мясо, оно так не будет красиво.
Normally, in Uzbekistan, you have to eat plov by hand. I have no experience to eat plov by hand. We will try. So normally you put something like this together, and then with one finger. Don't forget, like and subscribe.